Bezat Hashem, the Gemara discusses whether you're allowed to have Hana'a from Bigdei Kehuna. Alba feels that because of Aruba, we don't need a lot of table. So,
for you, Mr.
The Gemara says, Shamat Mina, Poshtanu Mekaplanu Manichenu Tanta Har Hashem. So the Mishnah over there said that when they take off the Bigdei Kehuna, they take them out, they fold them, and they put them onto their head. Shema Mina, we see from there, Bigdei Kehuna Nulei Nobem, that you're allowed to have Hana from the Bigdei Kehuna, because they were using them as a pillow. Says the Gemara, Lo Amar Papa, Lo Teima Tachad Rashehem, Ela Ema Keneged Rashehem. They didn't put them on the head, they put them opposite the head. Amar Misharshia. Albert, maybe you want to put that table over here.
Which one? Behind?
That one. Put it this way. This way. Right. Amar Rav Mishashia. Rav Mishashia says, Shamat Mina, we see from here, Tefillin, Minatzat Shapir Dami. That you could put Tefillin also on the side of your head, like we learned in the Gemara Berachot. That you put him Ben Kekar LeKesat, Shelo Keneged Rashehem. Look in Rashi. Shema mina midu mutar la nichan etzlo lo haishinan l'sheme yafiach. Rashi is continuing this idea that there's a problem of bigdei kehuna of sheme yafiach b'hem. That it has a kiddusha, I guess, like tefillin.
When you're saying on the side of the head, what does that mean?
Like, meaning you put it under your pillow, but not under your head, near where your head is, so that you can watch them.
Uh-huh.
Right? Rashi, tefillin min atzad, la nihan etzlo kishu yashen. You can put the tefillin on the side of your head. Hachinami mistabra. Says Gemara, makes sense. The keneged rashehin. That you're not putting them under your head, but you're putting them next to your head. The isal kada'atach tahat rashehin. If you think you're putting them under your head, tepuk lehmi shum kilayim. Hare, it looks, it's kilayim. The bigdei kehuna have kilayim in them. Jahaika Avnet. Javnet had kilaim. Unihi nami dinit nu lehenot bahim. Even if you want to say you could put them under your head, because you're allowed to have hana'a from them, hamit hanim kilaim, having benefit from kilaim. Hani haliman damar avneto shel kohen gadol. Zehu. It's good according to the opinion that says the Avnet of the Kohen Gadol on Yom HaKippurim is the Avnet of the Kohen Ediot all year. Like we said before, the rabbi that says that you could wear the Bigdei Kehuna of the Bigdei boots of the Kohen Gadol could be worn by a Kohen Ediot all year. So it's good because that was all boots and this is all boots, no problem. Ela leman de amar Avneto. Shul Kohen Gadol, lo zehu avneto shul Kohen Gadol, davneto of the of Shul Kohen Ediot, davneto the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur is not a avneto of the Kohen Ediot, but the Kohen Ediot is like the avneto of the Kohen Gadol all year, which had kilayim. Michael and Memo, what's the difference? What are you going to say? How are you allowed to put your head down on top of the kilayim? V'chitema. What are you going to say? Kilayim. Kilayim bilvisha. Veha'ala'a. Hu de'asur. You're not allowed to put kilayim on top of you. Behatza'a shari. But you're allowed to put it under you. Ve'atanya, we learn. Lo ya'ale alecha. Kilayim can't go on you. Avalata mutar la'tzia tachtecha. You're allowed to put it under you. That's me de'oraita. Aval.
So you
can
sleep on it, maybe?
No, see. And before we go through this, let's just go do the Rashi still here. Hani hahai de lohayish lekalayim. This what you're thinking, you could put it under you and you're not worried about kalayim. Man damar. Avneto shel kohen gadol, the avnet of the kohen gadol. Biyom ha-kippurim. Shush shel boots, which is made of only linen. Zeu avneto shel hediot kol yimot hashana. That's the same type of avnet that a kohen hediot uses all year. The enke lain bebigdei kohen hediot. There's no climb in the bigdei kohen hediot. Shapir is good. But if y'all lozehu, it's not the avnet of the kohen hediot all year. The shel hediot kol hashana shel kelaim. What are you going to say? So, what are you going to say that you let her put back in the Gemara? That you let her put kilayim under you? Vehatanya lo yale alecha, valatamuta letzio tachtecha. Can't be on you, but it can be under you. Aval amru chachamim. The rabbi said, asul asot, can you not let her put under you? Shemet techroch nima hat al bisarom. Maybe it will wrap around you, and then it will be over you. Vechitei mad. What?
You might even want straight.
Yeah. That you put something in between, so therefore there's no hashash of shemet techroch nima. Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Bazi, Amar Rabbi Shimon Levi, Amar Rabbi Mishum Kahala Kadisha Shibirushalayim. Afilu eser matzaot, even 10 mattresses or 10 mats, zeal gavze, one on top of the other, v'kilayim tachtehem, and kilayim is under them. Asul ishon alehem, you're not allowed to sleep on them. So under you is under you. It doesn't make a difference how many layers.
There's no
hanah from
it when you put it under.
We're afraid. Even
the ten levels might fall.
El alav. Must for you. Shema mina keneged rashehem. Must be it's not opposite the head. It's to the side. Shema mina. So that's a proof because there'd be no way to put it under your head. Ravashi amar. Le'olam tahat rashem. Really, it's under his head. V'haka mitan mikalayim. Isn't he benefiting from kalayim? Bigdei kehuna kashin hen. The bigdei kehuna.
How much hana he gets from that already? Even in the nimah. What kind of hana is that?
Enough to be azur.
Azur.
No, but you see hana. You're getting hana from it. He's going to warm his body. How much? Small. Okay. Is that hana? You feel the hana?
I ate a little bit of tarif. How much hana did I get?
Nothing.
Is it mutar?
Also, he's not doing it purpose. He might do it, not even purpose. No, it's very fine.
You know, you're putting the climb under you. Ravash Yamar Leolam Tahat Rashem. Really, I'll tell you, he put it under his head. How you tell me he's enjoying the kilayim? Bigdei kehuna kashin hen. The bigdei kehuna hard. Ki ha da amar Rav Huna bered Rav Yoshua. Hainam ta gamda de narash. This hard felt that comes from narash. Sharia, you'll let him put it under you, I guess. Rashi.
Namta
kashim hen. Ve'ena mehamemim. It doesn't warm you. Lefikach em by mishum kelaim. Namta levet filter abilaz. Gamda kashe shari em bo mishum kelaim de ha'ala'a. Dumya de levisha. De eat be hana'at chimum hu de asur. Because when it says ha'ala'a, it's only asur when it's like levisha. That it makes a hana'at chimum. But this stuff is hard, so it's not mehamem. Since it's not mehamem, it's mutar.
Is the kedusha in the clothes, Rabbi?
What?
Is the kedusha in the kohen clothing?
Yeah, for sure. No.
Like tefillin, is that what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. Or like the talit? Like tefillin, kedusha.
That's why Shemi Aviyah, man. No.
So
it seems like something that's hard and it's not the derech to use for, not the derech, something that's hard and it's not mehamem, you're allowed to wear, or you're allowed to put under you. I never understood exactly how this eno mehamem works.
delivery guy who puts it on his head.
What?
The delivery guy who puts it on his head is not
mechaber. That's something else. That's davar she'en mitkavim. But what does it mean that because it's hard, it's not mechamim? If you sleep under a carpet, it doesn't warm you. I mean, how hard was this felt? It wasn't like a board. I never understood it.
I have to try.
Kiha. Okay, so that's that. Says the Gemara Tashima. We'll bring another proof. B'gdei kehuna, hayotze b'em lemedina asur. To walk outside is a Beit HaMikdash is asur. Uba Mikdash, but in the Beit HaMikdash, he's allowed to wear it. Ben b'sha'at avodah, ben shelo b'sha'at avodah. During the avodah, not b'sha'at avodah. Ben b'sha'at avodah, ben shelo b'sha'at avodah mutar. Because the b'gdei kehuna were given the kohanim to use. Shmamina, that it's mutar. Why is it asur outside of the Beit HaMikdash? I would imagine that it's an isur de rabbanan. Rashi says, la medina asur, shenoheg ba derechol. He's treating them like his own clothing. But that's an isur de rabbanan. It's not an isur doretas. Gemara says, is that true that you're not allowed to wear them outside of the Beit HaMikdash? Medina lo vehatanya be'esrim v'hamisha betebet, and some have a girsa be'esrim v'hamisha be'sivan, or some have a girsa be'esrim v'had bo, some have be'kislev, different girsaot. Yom Har Gerizim hu, it's the day of Har Gerizim. Har Gerizim is where the Kutim lived. The Lola Misped. Yom shebikshu Kutim et bet Eloheinu Alexandrus Mokdun. It's a day. I don't know if it's the same day, but it's the day we overpowered. Shebikshu et kutim et bet Eloheinu, Alexandrus Mokdom. The kutim requested that the Beit HaMikdash should be given over to them from Alexander the Great, laharivo, to destroy it. Venetano lahem, he gave it to them. Baal ve'odiwa Shimon HaTzadik, they told Shimon HaTzadik what happened. Ma'asa, what did he do? Lavash b'gdei kehuna, he put on the b'gdei kehuna, and he wrapped himself in the b'gdei kehuna. Exactly what the lavash and netatef is, I'm not sure. He had the yakire Yisrael coming with him. Maybe it should be yakire Yerushalayim, which is a more familiar term. And they had torches in their hands. All night long, halalu holchim mitzad ze, halalu holchim mitzad ze. These were going on this side, and these were going on that side. Going on this side and that side sounds like they were walking parallel. But it's not Mr. Ben like that. It makes more sense that they were coming opposite each other, and maybe they saw them. I'm not sure. Ad sha'ala amud ha-shachar. Kivan sha'ala amud ha-shachar, and they were able to make out that there were people there. Amar lahem. So Alexander told his people, "Mi alalu, who are them? Amru lo Yehudim shemardu b'cha. These are the Jews that rebelled against you. Kivan shehigia laAntipatras, some place in Israel. Zarha hama, the sun shone. Upagu ze baze, and they met each other. Kivan shera'al Shimon HaTzadik, when he saw Shimon HaTzadik, yarad mi merkavto, he got off of his chariot. Vishtahava lefanav, and he bowed in front of him. Amru lo, so the people told him, Melech gadol kemotcha yishtahave liyudi ze, a great king like you should bow in front of this Jew. Amar lahem, he said, Demu diokno shel ze menatzach lefanai bebet milhamti. I see this guy's vision winning in front of me when I go to fight. Amar lahem, so he told the Jews, Lama batim, what'd you come? Amru, they said, Efshar bayit shemitpalim bo alecha, a home that they pray for you and your kingdom that it shouldn't be destroyed. Yet ucha of the kochavim la harivo, the goyim should trick you into destroying it. Amar lahem, he said, "Mi alalu? Who wants to trick me?" Amru lo kutim alalu. It's these kutim shomdim lefanecha that they're trying to trick you to destroy our Beit HaMikdash. Amar lahem, he told them, harehem misurim biyedchem. They're given over to you. Miyad, gruesome. Nikevum, they made holes in the bikvotehem. They made holes through the heels. Vetelaum biznavesusehem, and then they tied them to the tails of their horses. And they had them dragged through the thorns till they got to Har Gerizim with them. Kivan shehigiyu lahar Gerizim harshuhu, they plowed it over v'zaruhu karshinim, and they planted it with hops. Kederech shebikshu la'asol lebet Eloheinu, like they wanted to do to the Beit HaMikdash. So what do we quote the whole story for? What? Because he wore the Bigdei Kehuna outside of Beit HaMikdash.
This is an emergency case. You have to show. Is that...
For Jack, I call Mutar. Everything
not Mutar, but this is an emergency case. About how many times have happened these things?
An emergency.
Tell me how many times. We're not talking about going to the market, going to buy fruit and vegetables.
Ve'oto ayom, right? Ve'oto ayom that day, asau yom tov. Says Gemara, iba itema reuim lebigdei kuna. He had like the dummy set that wasn't yet kadosh. Iba itema et lasol laHashem eferu toratech.
This is Jack.
Rabbi.
Not so bad, Jack. Okay.
Almost. And I was there, Rabbi. Not good, is it?
You went Har Gerizim?
So the whole process of Kohanim.
Shema Minav, what they think is Kohanim.
Yeah.
Shema, right. Chazan HaKeneset notel Sefer Torah. The Chazan HaKeneset takes the Sefer Torah. Shema Minav, we see from here. Holkim Talmid, Holkim Kavod.
Eli, get me a Tere Asar and a Ezan Nehemiah.
Shema Minav, Holkim Kavod le Talmid b'mkom Arav. We see that we give Kavod to the Talmid in the place of the Rav. Like we spoke about giving Kavod to Yoav in front of David. Because over here, they're giving Kavod to the Shamosh and to the Misader and to that whole, the whole thing before the Kohen Gadol. Amar Abaye, kula mishum kavod do Kohen Gadol. It's not to give honor to these people. It's to show that the Kohen Gadol has a whole downstream under him that's subservient to him. So there's a bunch of people that are serving him. Rashi, the Tamid b'mkom Arav, the Rosh HaKeneset uliskam b'fnei Kohen Gadol, the enok k'memayet kavod Arav. It's not like lessening the kavod of the Kohen Gadol. So we answer no. Kula mishum kivodo do Kohen Gadol. Marim oto, we show. Sheesh sirarot harbe lemata mimenu. There's a lot of people beneath him. Aval be'alma en holkim lo. In general, you wouldn't give kavod to when it's not giving kavod to the higher one. We don't give kavod to the lower one. The Kohen Gadol omed. Michlal shu yoshev, was the Kohen Gadol sitting? He stands up and he reads. So he was sitting, right? Beha anan tenan. We learned.
Is it a tenan?
The reader was sitting?
The Kohen Gadol, they didn't have a Baal Koreh. The Kohen Gadol had to read himself. It sounds like the Kohen Gadol stood up to read. Yeah, you gotta sit to stand up. So the Ha'amar Mo, they want to change it to. We learned, En Yeshiva Ba'azara Ela L'malchei Beit David Bilvad. The only ones that let us sit in the Azara is the family, the kings from the family of David. Rashi dichtiv la'amod l'sharet o ha'om v'edim sham l'fnei Hashem v'lo matzino b'yeshiva. We didn't find that anybody could sit in the Azara.
There's plenty of chairs in the courts.
Ela l'malchei, that's not the Beit HaMikdash. Ela l'malchei Beit David sh'ne'emar v'yavo ha'melech David v'yeshev l'fnei Hashem. Rashi k'sh'amar lo natan ha'navi ata lo tevnei ha'bayit ki yimle'u yamecha. He sat in the Beit Hashem. Kanereh, whoever it was, had a din of Beit Hashem. It's funny because in David HaMelech's time, there was no official Beit Hashem. It was only a Bama. In Shiloh, there was a Mishkan, had a din of a Mishkan. In David HaMelech's time, there was the time of Nov and Giv'on, right? First it was Nov. Nov was Harev, then there was Giv'on. And Hashem spoke to Shlomo, B'Giv'on Hashem Nira. Hashem spoke to Shlomo at Giv'on. So the Bama Gedolah was in Giv'on. The Aron was in Yerushalayim. Neither one had a din of a Beit HaMikdash. It's coming out that we're learning a halakha for the Beit HaMikdash from something that wasn't even a Mishkan. It wasn't even an official Mishkan. So only David, Only David could say, "Keda Amar of Chizda beEzrat Nashim, Hachanami beEzrat Nashim." Just like Rav Chizda answered a different question like this, by saying it was in the Ezrat Nashim. So to over here, we're talking about the Kohen Gadol reading. He didn't read in the Azara proper. He read in the Ezrat Nashim. The Ezrat Nashim doesn't have a din of Azara. It has a din of Harabait. Who said?
There was no, oh, yeah?
I don't know. I doesn't say. Fehecha itmar did Rav Chizda. Where did Rav Chizda's... Where was Rav Chizda's statement said? Aha, on this case. Meiti, what's the good sign? They take out Meiti, but the Tanya, Heichan, Korimbo, where did they read the Torah? The Azara. They were reading in the Azara. Reb Lez ben Yaakov Omer Baharabait. It was on the Harabait. Shneemar. Vayikra bo lefne harichov asher lefne sharamayim. They read it in front of the street that goes in front of the sharamayim. The Amar of Chizda, the Ezrat Nashim. That was in, this what he said on Harabai, was in the Ezrat Nashim. Now the Gemara says, now we're going to go on to discuss that Ma'amad where Ezra was reading the Sefer Torah. Vayvarech Ezra Tashem HaElohim HaGadol. My Gadol. What does it mean? What's specified when it says HaGadol? Amar Rav Yosef Amar Rav. Rav Yosef says, they want to take out Rav. Shegidelo b'shem ha-meforash. That he said in the beracha, he said the shem ha-meforash. In the Beit HaMikdash, he said the shem ha-meforash. Rav Gidal amar, Baruch Hashem Elohei Yisrael, min ha-olam v'ad ha-olam. They were mitaken to say, min ha-olam v'ad ha-olam. That was that Ha'el HaGadol. He said that longer version of the beracha. Amar le'abaye. Abaye told Rav Gidal, they take out Rav Dimi. Amar le'abaya, abaya v'dilma shegidelo b'shem ha-meforash. Why don't you want to say that gidelo b'shem ha-meforash? Amar le, en omrim shem ha-meforash b'gvulim. You're not allowed to say the shem ha-meforash outside of the bet, outside of the azara. And the harabayit is considered b'gvulim. Rashi says, b'gvulim kol chutz la'azara kari gvulim. It says in the Torah, b'chol ha-makom asher azkir et shemi avo elecha u'berachticha. And the Targum, if I'm not mistaken, says, Asher Eten Reshut. Where's the Chumash?
What's that?
No, these are Nevi'im.
Ashko.
Even you get the Mikra'al Gidol Ol Shemot, Jimmy. Mikra'al Gidol Ol Shemot. I think, if I'm not mistaken, that's the Targum. And I think that's what we learned, that you're only allowed to say, and not everybody, but it's only the Shema Meforash is only allowed to be said in the what's it called? Do you have in the top one yet? No? Yitro. It's not on the top, it's just I'm bringing it in.
Same thing.
It's good enough. Counts. The end of the parasha. Mizbah Adama Tas Eliv is a Vachta Alavet Olotecha, Olotecha Vet Shelamecha Vet Sonecha Vet Bekarecha. Bechol Makom Asher Askiret Shemi Avo Elecha Uberachticha. So the Targum says, Di Ashre Shechinti Letaman. Rashi says, Bechol Makom Asher Askiret Shemi, Asher Eten Lecha Reshut, Laskir Shema Meforash Sheli, Sham Avo Elecha Uberachticha. Mikan Atalamed, Sheloni Tan Reshut. להזכיר שם המפורש, אלא במקום שהשכינה באה שם, וזה בית הבחירה. שם ניתן רשות לכהנים, להזכיר שם המפורש בנשיאות כפיים, לברך את העם. When they say ברכת כהנים, in the בית המקדש, the כהנים say the שם המפורש. That's towards the end of our parasha. So that's what Rav Gidal told Abaye. Says it can't be, they would say the שם המפורש in the Ezrat Nashim. Says Gemara, velo, they never said it. Ve'aketiv, it says, "Vayamod Ezra haSofer al Migdal Etz Asher Asul Adavar." Ve'amar Rav Gidal shegidelo b'shem ha-meforash. Right? Over there, it's like a little bit further. He says, "Migdal Etz Asher Asal Adavar." And over there he says, Shigidilo b'shem ha-mefurash. He's explaining what the Migdal is. What's the pasuk there? Yeah, so that's in Pasuk Dalit from that thing. Vayikra lefne arhov. Right? And it says, Vayamod Ezra sofer al migdal etz asher asu lo v'atzu matatya v'shem arav. And of Gidal says Shigidol. Now I don't understand what we're saying, because lechaora it's the same story here. The pasuk says, "Ve'yasefu kol ha'am ki'ish echad el rehov asher lefnei shar ha'mayim." Ve'yomeru le'Ezra sofer la'vi et sefer Torat Moshe she'tziva Adonai et Yisrael. Ve'yavi Ezra ha'kohen et ha'Torah lefnei ha'kahal mi'ish ve'ad isha ve'chol mevin. So it's Rosh Hashanah. Vayikra bo lefne harchov asher lefne sha'ar ha'mayim. Min ha'or ad machatzit ha'yom. Long kiryat ha'Torah. Neged ha'anashim v'hanashim v'hamevinim. Ve'ozne kol ha'am el sefer ha'Torah. Vayamod Ezra sofer al migdal etz asher asu ladavar. Vayamod etzlo matatya v'shema v'aniya v'uriya v'chelkiya v'masiya v'yemino. ומשמאלו פדיה ומישאל מלכיה וחושם וחשום וחשבדנה זכריה משולם. ויפתח עזרא ספר לעיני כל העם, כי מעל כל העם היה, כוסמזונס מגדל וכפתחו, עמדו כל העם. ויברך עזרא את אדוני האלוהים הגדול, ויענו כל העם אמן אמן, במו על ידיהם, ויקטו וישתחוו לאדוני אפיים ארצה. So, over here, it's the same story. And Rav Gidol is saying about that, Shigidilo b'shem ha-mefurash. And over here, someone put Vam Rav Yehuda Marav. So what's the question? The Bach changes the pasuk. ולא והכתיב, ויזעקו בקול גדול אל אדוני אלוהיהם. He says, that can't be, because the other one is the same thing. This is a different story. And it says, ויזעקו בקול גדול אל אדוני אלוהיהם. And they were, קול גדול means that they said the שם מפורש. So he says, הוראת שעה הייתה. That was הוראת שעה. Where's this pasuk? Ve'itzaku el Adonai Elohim bekol gadol. That's a different pasuk in a different place. That's in the Hemya Tet. This is when they were doing teshuvah. The Hemya Tet Dalet. Ubiyom 24 lachodesh hazeh ne'esfu b'nei Yisrael b'tzom u'b'sakim v'adama alehem ve'ibadelu zere Yisrael mikol b'nei me'nehar. ויעמדו ויתוודו על חטאותם ועוונות אבותיהם. ויקומו על עמדם ויקראו בספר תורת אדוני אלוהיהם רביעית היום. רביעית היום מתוודים ומשתחווים. ויעקם ומעלה אלוהים ישונם. ויזעקו בקול גדול אל אדוני אלוהיהם. So he's understanding the call gadol refers to the שם המפורש. Right? So how were they able to say the שם המפורש outside of the בית המקדש? So it's הוראת שעה הייתה. Rashi explains, doesn't explain. Okay, we'll see in a minute what the Hora'at Shaita. Right? My Amur, what did they say? Amar Rav, Itaymer Rabbi Yohanan, Baya Baya. Rashi says, Lashon Za'aka V'Kublanat, it's a Lashon of wailing and complaint. Hainu Hai Da'achrevel Mikdasha. This is the cause that caused the Beit HaMikdash to be destroyed. V'Kalya Lehechalai. It caused the Hechal to be burnt. V'katlinu lekulu tzadike, it caused all the tzadikim to be burnt, to be killed. V'aglinu liYisrael me'arehon, it caused all the Jewish people to go into galut. V'aday miraked benan, and it's still dancing among us. What is he talking about, Rashi? Mevakshim rachamim, shimaser biyadam yetzer hara shel avodat kochavim. says the Avodah Zarah, the Yetzirah of Avodah Zarah is what caused all that destruction, and it's still happening. They're still marrying Goyot. Klum Yahiftelan. Why did you give us the Yetzirah of Avodah Zarah? Ela Likbule Be'agra. To get reward. Lo ihu ba'inan ve'lo agre ba'inan. We don't want it and we don't want its reward. Nafa lehu pitka mirki'a. To have a ketiv be'emet. A paper fell from Shamayim that said emet. Kilomar maskim ani imachem. I agree with your idea. Now go do it. Amar Rav Hanina shma mina. We see hotamo shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu emet. Because that was his signature. Otvu betanita tlata yamin. They fasted for 3 days v'tlata liliyata. And 3 nights. Masruhu nihalihu. They gave over the Yetzirah to them. Nafak ata kiguria denura. It came out like a young lion. A fire. Mibed kochei kodashim, from the kodesh kodashim. Amar lehu navi Yisrael. The navi told Yisrael, Hanu yitzra da avodah kochavim. That's the Yetzirah of avodah zarah. Shneimar vayomer zot harisha'ah. That's the wickedness. I'll read you the pasuk. Interesting nevuah. Va'ashuv va'esa enai va'ere v'ine megila afa. Megila was flying. Va'yomer elai ma ata ro'e va'amar hineh ro'e megila afa ar orka 20 ba'ama ve'rochba 10 ba'ama. Va'yomer elai zot ha'ala ha'yotzet al penei kol ha'aretz. Ki kol ha'gonev mize kamo ha'nika v'chol ha'nishba mize kamo ha'nika. Hotzeti ha'ne'um Adonai tzvot u'ba el bet ha'ganav. ואל בית הנשבע בשביל השקל, ולענה בתוך ביתו, וחילתו, ואת עצה ואת אבניו. ויצא. ויצא המלאך, ואם אלי סנה, אני יכול מה יוצא את זאת. גם see what else is coming out of the קודש קודשי. ואומר מי, ואומר זאת האפה. You're going to see a measure coming out. ויאמר זאת עינם בכל הארץ. This is the cheating. ויאמר והנה כיכר עופרת נישאת. It was a block of lead. וזאת אישה אחת יושבת בתוך האפה. And there was a lady sitting inside of it. ויאמר זאת הרשעה. וישלך אותה אל תוך האפה. וישלך את אבן העופרת אל פיה. That's the pasuk. Zot harisha'ah, the understanding is talking about the lion that came out of the Kodesh Kodashim, that was the Yetzirah of Avodah Zarah. Even though it sounds like, it says in the pasuk there was a lady sitting there, the Gemara is understanding it a little bit differently. Right, vayomer zot. So what did the Gemara say? Behadi de tafsua, while they caught it, ishtamit binta mimazye. One hair fell out from his hair. Verama kala, and a voice came out. Ve'azil kale arva me'ah parse, and the sound went 400 parsa. Rashi says, Amar le navi Zecharia ben Idu, benita se'ar. So Amru heichi na'avid. What should we do? Dilma hasvi shalom merachme ale min Shemaya. Maybe they'll have mercy on Shemaim, I guess, because he's crying so much. Amar lehu navi shadyu beduda de avra. Put him in a pot of lead. Behafyu lefuma beavra, and cover the mouth with lead. De avra mishav shayv kala. Lead deadens the sound. Shne emar vayomer zot harisha'am. Vayashlech ota el tocha efa. Vayashlech et ever haoferet el piha. The Maharsha explains that the hair that came, he says, the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed because of Avodah Zarah. He says, but that's why Nebuchadnezzar was compared to an Ari. He says this: the second Beit HaMikdash was also destined to be destroyed by Edom, and that was the completion of the destruction of the first Beit HaMikdash. That's why, even though now they were getting rid of the Yetzer of Avodah Zarah, it was still destined to be destroyed. So that's why one hair fell out, which refers to Seir, which is Edom, who's going to destroy the second Beit HaMikdash. So he says, so they pray that he shouldn't be mivatel. I'm not sure exactly what the praying or what the rahamim is going to be. That Seir is going to get more power. So they closed it up so that the noise shouldn't come. Difficult to understand. Amru, they said, Ho'il ve'et ratzonu, because it's a time of favor that we were able to destroy this Yetzer'ara, let's pray to get rid of the Yetzer'ara of Zenut, Rashi. Doesn't say. Okay, Ba'o Rahameh, they prayed v'imsar bi'adayu, they got that one too. Now it doesn't say that it was a lion that came out. Amar lehu, he told them, or the Navi told them. He says the Yetzirah told them. Okay. Hazud ikatlu lehahu gavra. If you kill this person, the Yetzir of Avira, Kalya Alma, the world will be destroyed. Habshut lata yome. They captured him for 3 days. They looked for a fresh egg in the whole Israel, and they couldn't find it. Look in Rashi. An egg, fresh egg. The heat stopped from the stomach. Even those that the chicken already was working on, they weren't ripening in the stomach. So they realized that's not going to work. Amri hechi na'avid. Nikhtele, should we kill him? Kalya alma, the world will just be destroyed. There won't be any priyavirivya. Nivera hamea palga, should we pray for hef? Rashi says, she hesholed ba'adam li zakek li ishto. A person should only want his wife and not anybody else. Palga birkiya lo yavi. They're not going to give us hef. I don't know. Kachlinu le'ene. They put a lot of kahal in the eyes to blind it or to weaken it. Vishafkuhu, and they let him go. The ahani, what that blinding of the eyes did, the lo migru be le'inish bekrefte, that a person is not attracted to his close relatives. V'ma'arava matnu hachi. In Eretz Yisrael, they taught it the way we said it. Rav Gidal Amar, Rav Gidal said, Umat Nuhachi, they said it like this. Rav Gidal Amar, Gidelo Gadol, Shigidelo B'Shem HaMeforash. But Rav Matna Amar, no. What they say Agadol is, Ha'el Agadol Agibor V'Hanora. They went back to saying, Ha'el Agadol Agibor V'Hanora. That was Agadol. That's what Israel did Agadol, Rashi. Ha'el Agadol Agibor V'Hanora, Shelo Yisa Panim. That's a pasuk that Moshe said. So what's the story there? How did Rav Matna Matya l'Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi? It's Misayeya. They changed the good side. Helps Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi. Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, Lama nekra sheman anshe kenesed agedola. Why they called the anshe kenesed agedola? Sheheziru atara liyoshna. They brought the crown of Hashem back to its old way. Ata Moshe amar el agedol agibor vanora. Ata Yirmiyah ve'amar nochrim mekarkerim be'echalo. The goyim are partying in the hechal. Ayen orotav. Where is this all? Lo amar nora. He stopped saying nora. Ata Daniel amar nochrim mishtabdim be'banav. The goyim are enslaving his sons. Ayeh givurotav. Where is his might? Lo amar gibor. He stopped saying gibor. Atu inu. They came ve'amru adrabah. Zui givurat givurato. That's the greatness of his might. Shekoveshet yitzro. He conquers his will. Shenoten erech hapaim l'reshaim. He's patient with the reshaim. Ve'eluhen norotav. And these are his noraot. Shel male moraot shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If not for Hashem's fear, heyachuma ahat yicholah letkayem ben haumot. How could one nation stay among all the nations? But Rabbanan, Hechi Avdi Hachi, how did the rabbis do that? Meaning Yirmiyah and Daniel. The Akri Takanta de Takin Moshe. Moshe said to say, Ela Gadol Gibor Vanora. How do you approve that? Amar Bilazar Mitoch, Shiodim Bakadosh Baruchush Amitihu, because they know Hashem is true. And their midah was every word that they said in the tefillah, they felt it. If these two words they couldn't feel because of whatever reason, they knew Hashem would rather that they didn't say it. That's for people that that actually feel. Rashi, Ovdei kochavim mekarkirim beechalo shera'a sarei Nebuchadnezzar nechnasim laechal umereim bo kechol retzonam. ולא אמר נורא בפרשת הנה חנמאל כתיב עושה חסד לאלפים ומשלם אבון אבות אל חק ביניהם אחריהם האל הגדול והגיבור השם צבאות שמו. He left out נורא. דניאל לא אמר גיבור בתפילתו בספרו. And דניאל, because he didn't feel it.
He has to come back, no?
דניאל לא אמר גיבור בתפילתו בספרו. עובדי כוכבים משתבדים בבניו זה 70 שנה. So he answered, זוהי גבורתו. שכובש יצרו כל השנים הללו שנשתעבדו בהם ומעריך אפו he's patient על כל הגזרות שגוזרים על בניו ואלו הן נוראותיו and these are his awe של מלא מוראות not for the fear that they had of him how come they didn't kill him מן יום החורבן אתה למד נוראותיו שכל האומות נאספו להשמידם all the nations wanted to destroy the Jewish people ונתקיימו מהם and they're still there ורבנן ירמיה ודניאל שהוא אמיתי מסכים על האמת ושונא את השקר. So he didn't say what they didn't feel him in. וקורא אחרמות ואח בעשור. ורמינו, I'll ask you a question. מדלגים בנביא, you're allowed to skip in נביא, ואין מדלגים בתורה, and you can't skip in the Torah. So how did he read the Torah and skip from אחרמות, תאמור? לא קשה. כאן בכדי שיפסיק התורגמן, כאן בכדי שלא יפסיק התורגמן. You're not allowed to skip. If it's after the Turgiman translates, you're going to have to wait. But if it's less than that, it's okay. V'ha'ala katani, in that Mishnah it says, medalgim benavi, ve'en medalgim b'torah. You can skip in Navi, you can't skip in Torah. Ve'ad kama medaleg, how much could you skip? Yani, in Navi, bechdeh shelo yafsik ha'Turgiman, until the Turgiman doesn't stop. Ha'batorah, klal klalo. In Torah, you can't skip at all. Says Gemara, lo, sorry, Amar Abaye, lo kasha. In the Torah, if you want to skip and go to a different topic, you're not allowed. But in the same inyan in Torah, you're allowed to skip. And we have a braita to prove it. You could skip in the Torah in the same inyan. By Navi, you could skip in two inyanim. In both places, enough time that the Turgiman doesn't stop translating. ואין מדלגים מנבי לנבי, but you can't skip from נבי to נבי. ובנבי של שני מעשר, meaning you can't skip from ישעיה, ירמיה, and so on. ובנבי של שני מעשר, but in תרי עשר מדלגים, because it's all small, it's all like one ספר. בלבד שלא ידלג מסוף הספר לתחילתו. Even when we say you skip in the נבי, you can't skip backwards.
You can go forward,
not
backwards.
The head of Kalaf, they used to read from a Kalaf. ברוך אדוני לעולם, אמן ואמן. Thank you.